of our lovely panel here, and they'll talk a little bit about Anarchy Online, and then we'll probably shoot into Q&A as to basically in the panel. And then we'll give away some stuff. We brought a whole bunch of swag for everyone who did. It's really good. So we got a variety of new stuff, new t-shirts, which I'm not wearing, unfortunately. I wanted to wear it, but not enough time. We have lots of mouse pads and new stickers, all EO themed, all different clans, and so forth. Go ahead.
Hi guys, my name is Brad McAtee, also known as Ken Tai. I'm a senior designer on Anarchy Online.
My name is Scott Jr. My name is Nofex Ngam. I'm the customer service manager and the QA manager for the US office.
Hello, my name is Colin Craig. I'm Means Ngam and I'm the game director.
He's the rock star.
Anyway, I wanted to talk. Could you guys hear me okay, or do I need to be the mic? Excellent. Even the guy in the back. And the other guy in the back. You wouldn't believe what you just missed.
It was awesome.
It was incredible. Well, I wanted to talk a little bit today, real quick, before we get started with questions, about what we're up to in general with the game. As you can see, it's kind of blank.
It's number.
It's, yeah. A little snowstorm. Remind me of home, Canada. What we've been working on for the last few months, it's unusual, because normally in this kind of circumstance, I haven't been talking to people every single week for an entire year. You have a basic idea of what we're up to, but I wanted to more confirm kind of the spirit we were going forward with. We have nothing here right now, because we're not working on anything that's big and sexy and new and something that we're going to put in videos and broadcast it across the internet. There's no sexy, there's no new. What we're doing now is we're kind of embracing the fact that we're 8 years old now. 8 years we spent together. It's incredible. We've got to the point now where every single member of the team, at one point or another, came from your seats. Every single member of staff has been a player of video. So with that kind of passion for the product, now what we're doing is we're sitting together and thinking, okay, we have a little time now before we have to put together the next big, sexy kind of expansion booster. We're going to invest some time in what matters to the player base. When we get comments on the forums and all the emails we receive, it's not, hey, Colin, can you please make another expansion right now? It's not that. It's, this happened to me today, and it was really fucking annoying. I'm quitting because this happened to me today. Two of my friends joined us to play the game, and they quit after 2 days because they couldn't figure out what the hell was going on. What we're doing right now, and over the next 6 months, is we're taking the time to isolate the issues that bother the player base on a daily basis, and areas that we really need to improve on. I've been speaking weekly to you guys about the possibilities of an in-game mail system. How nice would that be, that we don't have to move it to one character, then move it to another one? We can just walk over to that terminal, put the item in, and send it where it's goddamn supposed to go. Yes. So we're taking the time now to invest in these small, little niggling details that should have been gone 5 years ago, but we're going to try and get rid of them all now. So Glenn mentioned today we're having a bit of a QA session, but that doesn't always have to be phrased as a question. What we're also looking to get from you guys today, we get feedback from the forums all the time, but the forums isn't the entire player base. I'm sure you guys are aware of this. You'll see, you know, 200 people on the forum screaming about, oh God, you guys need to work on this issue or this isn't fair, and everybody else who plays the game but doesn't post. There's a lot of you guys that don't post because you've got other things to do, like playing the game.
That's something to escape up on posting.
Yeah, because you never know where it's going to go, and it's a lot of noise. It's a lot of noise. So we're hoping today to get some feedback from the players who aren't posting all the time, the people who are here in the flesh, you know, at the event, to tell us what you think and where you'd like to see improvement, or direction you'd like to see the game, and we want your opinions as well as your questions. And I've never, oh God, no, no, spam. But no, we're here in person to try and get your impressions as to where you'd like the game to go, and hopefully get some actual feedback on where we've been going. Because this isn't something we started today. I'm not walking in the room and saying, oh, we're going to start improving areas of the game. We've been working on this for quite some time. We've got our city's instance now, thank God. No more limited real estate. Every guild that wants their city, I'm suddenly distracted. I have no idea why. When I spoke to my wife today about doing this, this didn't come up.
But you did know.
No idea. Yeah, but hopefully some feedback on the direction we've been taking. I say to the team all the time, I can try my best to discern what's the best idea, but the more opinion that we get, the more ideas that we get from the player base and, from the loyal fans that we've had for this long, the better. I was writing to somebody today who was saying one of their characters had 500 days played. That's 524-hour periods in AO on one character. It's amazing, the amount of time and effort that's, yeah.
People in the audience go, that's nuts.
I'm only up to that for
but it's amazing. Anyway, that was just the general tone. And this is why there's nothing here. Because everything that would be here would be things you guys have seen before. We're just going to be taking these things, streamlining them, trying to make them more efficient, trying to make them make sense. Should all, hopefully, come into place. We've had, of course, balancing. This is where the rocks start flying. Balancing concerns we're going to be trying to start to address. We've got a lot of dirty plans on paper at the moment that we're hoping to start pushing into test lab and pushing into reality in the very near future. But we've been a little, you guys might have noticed, a little kind of thin on the detail of what we're going to do because we want the larger plan in place before we start. I can't just go on the page and go, yeah, I'm decided to make fixers faster. Because everyone's like, but then they'll be faster. They just start more argument as opposed to satisfying questions and curiosity. So anyway, I think we'll maybe you guys have suffered enough with me speaking for a long period of time. Glenn will come around and ask questions, and hopefully we have reasonable answers for some of them. And we'll do our best. Okay. Thank you. And it's great to see everybody.
So, he's our first victim.
I don't know. I don't need the mic. All right, here's my first question. I know that with the new engine, there's going to have to be a lot of streamlining of the actual gameplay. In streamlining the gameplay, are you looking to lessen the intelligence quotient I think a lot of fears. It's less a question and more a shoot down the rumor. Wowification is another phrase that comes to mind. Are you going to be lessening the skill sets, lessening the diversity in order to create a more streamlined playstyle?
Okay. The engine and the streamlining, the transition to the new Conan engine, it's just going to make things pretty. It has nothing to do at all, and this comes up again and again, and it's not just you, with the way you interact with the game world and the way you develop your characters. It's about when you arrive on that beach for the first time, which we might change. You arrive on that beach for the first time, you're going to turn around, and you're not going to be like, wow, that's really old water. And hopefully the cliff is going to look like a cliff. Yeah, and the sand will hopefully look like sand. It's about trying to take the, because we all love the game, but we've kind of fallen in love with it. There's a romantic association with it for us. And when you can look at it with brand new eyes, just try and think, okay, I just looked at Conan, and now I'm going to look at AO right now, and you go, oh, Jesus.